बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम एंड वेलकम टू वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज़ फॉर द कोर्स नंबर 404 विच इज़ मैप वर्क एंड फील्ड सर्वेइंग। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल लर्न अबाउट कोनिकल प्रोजेक्शन एंड द टाइप ऑफ कोनिकल प्रोजेक्शन विच वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस विल बी द कोनिकल प्रोजेक्शन विद वन स्टैंडर्ड पैरेलल। वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग सम ऑफ द concepts, underlying concepts for this projection, and we will be constructing a conical projection with one standard parallel. So let's begin. When it comes to projections and the construction of projections, these are the parts of practical geography where we have to construct various things required. So for construction of any projection, we have a certain question. So here we have the question for conical projection. The questions are generally like this. So the question is, draw a conical projection with one standard parallel for the area bound between 15 degrees north to 75 degree north latitude parallel and 30 degree west to 60 degree east longitude meridian using RF 1:125,000,000 and the projection interval of 15 degrees. So here are certain terminologies in this question which needs explanation. First thing, the conical projection. So for that we need to know what a projection is. So simply, in simple words, projection is the method to convert a three-dimensional earth, because earth is not a flat shaped body, it is a three-dimensional body just like a ball. So when we are trying to depict the earth on a flat surface, that is the map, we need to have certain changes. So that change from three-dimensional ball like earth onto the flat map, that process is called as projection. And now, what is conical projection? So conical projection is done when the map or the paper surface is kept around the globe just like a cone. So as you can see here, the paper is folded as a cone, and because of this cone shape, this projection is named as a conical projection. So this is the reason this projection is conical. And now the second terminology in the question was standard parallel. So now we need to know what a standard parallel is. So firstly, parallel are the lines of latitudes which run on the surface of Earth. These are imaginary lines. So you see here, this is a parallel, and more clearly in this diagram over here, these lines of latitudes, when we connect different points of latitude of same value, then we have a parallel. In simple words, latitude and parallel look the same. The only difference is latitude is a point while parallel is a line. So parallel is a line of latitude. The cone which is wrapped around the globe, it touches the globe at a line or at any particular parallel. For example, over here in this diagram, this blue colored cone is touching the globe along this blue colored line. So this line corresponds to a parallel. It can be any parallel, but generally we take some special parallels for these projections. So a standard parallel is the point of contact, the line of contact between the cone and the globe. The line of contact between the cone and the globe is a standard parallel. Now here you can see, this is the reason I have written parallel in bracket along with latitude. Like when we talk about the degree thing, we talk about the latitude, and when we talk about the whole line which connect all the degrees in a circular form, so that is a parallel. Now similarly, longitude, the lines which run from north pole to south pole, the imaginary lines, longitudes are points or degrees while meridians are the lines. So the parallel and meridians, these are the two terminologies used for the lines in a projection, lines on the surface of Earth which are imaginary, while latitude and longitude are points or degrees on the surface of Earth. So the final projection which we will make will have parallels and meridians in it, and the labels of latitudes and longitudes on those parallels and meridians. Third thing in the question is the RF. This is the representative fraction. It's a scale which is used to draw the model of Earth on a paper, because Earth is so big, we cannot draw the big Earth on a small paper. So we need some conversions, some changings, some scaling. So that scaling is generally done by RF, or the representative fraction. Third thing in the question, the next thing in the question is the projection interval. So the interval of projection given is 15 degrees. We will discuss this interval thing in a while. Let's discuss central meridian for now. Central meridian is the vertical line or the line of longitude which lies exactly in the middle of our required projection. So it is the middle line. And how we will find the middle line or the central meridian? We will simply find out the middle value of the range which is given in the question. So this is the range given in the question, from 30 degree west to 60 degree east longitude. We will make a list of longitudes, the meridians, and from there we will find out which one is the central meridian. We will discuss the calculation of central meridian in a while. Now let's begin the construction of conical projection with one standard parallel. So step number one, of course, we have the RF given in the question. So using that RF, we need to calculate the reduced radius of Earth, because we cannot draw the actual Earth. So we need a reduced radius for a circle which will be used as a representation of Earth on the paper. So to calculate the reduced radius, we need to find out the actual radius of Earth, and we divide the actual radius of Earth with the ground value of RF. So here we have the RF 1:125,000,000, and remember there are six zeros in a million. So this figure is the RF ground value, while this number 1 is the map value. So we need to use this ground value in this formula, RF ground value, and the actual radius of Earth, it's written over here, it's 250,000,000 inches. Or if you want to use the MKS system, then the radius of Earth is 635,000,000 centimeters. We will use the inch unit for this projection construction. So we have simply divided the actual radius, which is 250,000,000, with the RF ground value, that is 125,000,000, and the reduced radius is 2 inches. So after finding the reduced radius, we need to select the standard parallel. Sometimes the standard parallel is written in the questions, while sometimes it's not written in the question. So in case the standard parallel is not mentioned in the question, here is how we can find the value of standard parallel. The projection interval was 15 degrees. Here in the question we see the projection interval, it was 15 degrees. So we will use this interval to make a list of all possible parallels. The range of parallel is 15 degree north to 75 degree north. So we, starting from 15 degree north to 75 degree north, we will keep an interval of 15 degrees to make a list of possible parallels. So here we have made the list of parallels: 15, followed by 30, then 45, then 60, and then 75. And notice one thing, that I have written these values vertically, because the parallels are arranged vertically on the globe or a projection. These will be labeled vertically, like 15 degree will be at bottom, then 30 degree will be just above the 15 degree. So after making the list vertically, just for our convenience, we will find out the middle value. So leaving two values at the top, two values at the bottom, we have one value in the middle, which is 45 degree north. So the line of 45 degree north will be our standard parallel. Similarly, in step number 3, we need to select the central meridian. So to select the central meridian, again looking at the interval given in the question and the range of meridians given in the question, we will make the list of all possible meridians for projection. So I have made the list of all possible projections, starting from 30 degree west to 15, because we are moving towards east, that's why here the values are decreasing. 30 degree west, 15 degree west, and then of course after 50 we have the 0 degrees, which is called as the prime meridian. Then 15 degree east, 30 degree east, 45 degree east, and 60 degree east. So these are all the possible meridians which will be drawn in this conical projection. Again, what I have done and what we have to do is to find out the middle value. So leaving three values on the right side and three values on the left side, we have the middle value, which is 15 degree east. So this will be our central meridian. Generally, the prime meridian is kept as a central meridian if the values on both sides are same. Like here we have 30 degree west, but there we have 60 degree. But if the question had been like this, 60 degree west to 60 degree east, then of course the central meridian would be the actual prime meridian, which is zero. But I have taken an example just to show that if you do not know how to find out the central meridian, then this is the way. Just make a list of all the possible meridians and make them horizontal, because the labeling will be done horizontally on the projection, and then find out the middle value, which will be our central meridian. So that was the calculation part, where we have calculated the reduced radius, and then we have found out the standard parallel and the central meridian. Now we will construct the projection. This is done in two steps. First one, we make a circle that will be representing the earth, and that circle I name it as projection base, because with the help of the values and lengths calculated in the projection base, we make the actual projection. That's why I call it as a projection base. So within a projection base, first thing is to draw a circle with the reduced radius, which was calculated in step number 1. So this was the radius which was calculated, which is 2 inches. So we have to draw a circle with radius 2 inches. So here, taking the reduced radius of 2 inches, we are opening an arc of 2 inches, and then we will make the circle. Now if you see, I have already made the projection using pencil, because the best thing is to draw a projection with pencil, but here I am using this marker just to make it more clear on the screen. So here we have drawn the circle of 2 inches radius. Now the next step is to mark a quadrant within the circle by drawing a horizontal line for equator and a vertical line for marking the north pole, because this projection lies in the northern hemisphere. So we will be marking the north pole. So here, from the center, a horizontal line. We will make a horizontal line for equator. And this should be done with precision. Better to use the mechanical pencil for the construction of. Now name the center as C and the outer circumference point as E, because E for equator, we are making this for equator, that's why C for center, E for equator. Now make the vertical line for North Pole and extend it outside the circle. Now we will name the North Pole as N. Now we have a quadrant here, and we will be doing all the working within this quadrant. This part of circle is not required for this projection anymore, so this quadrant will be used now. So the next step is to mark two angles in the quadrant, one with the value of projection interval which was given in the question, it was 15 degrees, and second angle will be marked for the standard parallel value, which was 45 degrees. Projection interval of 15 degrees and standard parallel of 45 degrees north. Now using protractor or D, we will mark the interval and the standard parallel. And 45 degrees for the standard parallel. Now we will connect those points with the center, that is C, and we will name it as I, since it is the interval angle, that's why I am naming it as I. And now we will make the standard parallel, and this will be named as S for standard parallel. Now this distance between E and I will be used as the interval between parallels, the distance between different parallels in this projection. So we'll save this for later use. So the next step is to make a small quadrant from center C, and the radius of that quadrant will be equal to the distance between E and I we have just marked. So using the distance between E and I, we will make a quadrant from center C. So this is the quadrant. So the next step is to draw a line which should be perpendicular to the line CN, the vertical line of the quadrant, and that line should touch the point where the new smaller quadrant meets the standard parallel. And this line will be parallel to CE, the horizontal line as well. Let's see how it is done. So now, from the line CN, we are drawing a perpendicular which should touch the point, which should touch the standard parallel. So you can use set square for here, for this process. So the contact point of the new quadrant and the standard parallel, and name it as XY. This will be the distance between meridians. We will be using all these distances in the actual projection construction. Now the next step is to draw a tangent to CS, that is the standard parallel, and that tangent will be meeting the line CN, and that meeting will take place outside the circle. Let's have a look how it is done. Now keeping the D at the standard parallel, we will, keeping the point 0 at standard parallel, we will mark 90 degree, the tangent, and then we will connect point S with the line CN, and we will name this new connecting point as P. This will be pole in the actual projection. So this is called as the projection basis. All the different values and labels, all the different distances, like this parallel distance, the meridian distance between X and Y, and the distance between S and P, these will be used for actual projection. Now for the actual projection, we first thing is to draw a vertical line exactly in the middle of the page of indefinite length. We can adjust the length of the line by erasing out the extra part later on. And this line will be our central meridian. So in the center of the page, we are drawing the central meridian. This will be named as P, the pole. So the next step is to draw the standard parallel in the form of an arc, and this will be drawn by making an arc from point P, and the radius of that arc will be equal to the distance between S and P in the projection base. So let's have a look how it could be done. So now we will open an arc equals to the distance between S and P as shown over here, and keeping the compass point at point P, we will make an arc, and this arc will be the standard parallel. So label the standard parallel 45 degree north, and along with that write SP, stands for standard parallel. So after that we have to mark the parallel distance along the central meridian, and for that we will be using the distance between E and I in the projection base, and we will mark parallels distances along the central meridian. And to check how many number of parallels will be made above the standard parallel and below the standard parallel, we will refer to step number 2, where we have made the list of possible parallels. So here is the list of parallels. So 2 parallels above the standard parallel and 2 parallels below the standard parallel. So now let's construct it. So we will take the distance between I and E from the projection base. We will open the arc, and then starting from the standard parallel, we will mark the parallel along the central meridian. This green line is the central meridian, and we have marked 2 parallel markings above it, and now we are marking 2 more below the standard parallel. So this orange line is the standard parallel, the green one, and the green line is the central meridian. In the next step, we will make concentric arcs keeping the compass point at P. We will make arcs for each parallel, and we will label those parallel according to the list in step number 2. So here is how it is done. Keeping the compass needle at point P, opening an arc equals to the first marking on the central meridian. We have made the arc. This is a parallel. Now we will open another arc radius from the second marking, and we will make the second parallel. Similarly, we will make the third one by opening an arc equals to the third marking over here, and then we have the third parallel. And lastly, we will make the fourth one. Remember to label these parallels according to the list from step number 2. Here the list is written, so label these 30 degree north and 15 degree north. So we have all the parallels done, which are in the form of arc. Next step is to mark the meridian distances along the standard parallel, and this will be done by taking an arc equals to the distance between X and Y. And for the number of meridians, again we will refer to the list in step number 3, the list of central meridians. So let's have a look how this step will be performed. So we will first label the central meridian, which is 15 degree east, now taking the meridian distance, which is equals to x and y on the projection base, and we will mark the meridian points along the standard parallel, the orange colored line. We will mark the meridian. So according to the list, you see we have three meridians to the left and three meridians to the right. So we are making, we have already made three marking on the left. Now we are marking the three remaining ones on the right. And the last step will be to join the meridian markings along the standard parallel with point P, and we will label the meridians according to the list in step number 3. So let's have a look how this will be performed. So joining P with the marking along the standard parallel, we will extend it up to the last parallel over here. So again, from point P we will connect and we will extend it up to the last meridian, last parallel. And you can always adjust the length by erasing the extra part. I have kept some extra part outside because I feel when we keep some of the parts outside, it's easier to label, especially at the corner at this point. So it's up to you. You can erase this whole part or you can keep a little part outside just for the ease of labeling. Now we will label these meridians according to the list. I have already written the list along with the projection construction so that it's easier. So the labelings of all the meridians. And finally, our projection is complete, and the final outcome of the projection will look like this. So this is conical projection with one standard parallel. So we will see you in the next video with conical projection with two standard parallel. Till then, thank you very much for watching.